Did Google Maps change colors? It sure did, but that's not the only new update. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and today I'm exploring all the new Google Maps updates just in time to make your holiday travel a little easier. You will notice these changes across iOS and Android devices, and some of these changes on desktop as well. So let's start with that Google Maps color change everyone is talking about. There's more than meets the eye here. First, if you haven't opened Maps on Android since the new color change, you may also have a notice on the bottom of Google Maps asking you if you'd like to use Maps in dark theme. You can choose from light theme, dark theme, or same as device. If you don't have this or you want to change your theme at any time, tap on your profile icon in the top right, tap on settings, then tap on theme. This works the same on iOS, by the way, except under your Google Maps settings, it's found in the dark mode option. But back to the main color change in Google Maps. Across desktop and mobile, you're gonna notice that roads are no longer white and yellow. Roads are instead gray, and bodies of water are a lighter blue. They're almost teal-like on some devices. Forested areas are now a darker shade of green. The route color is now a much darker blue. It's actually quite vibrant. And major highways are a bit of a darker gray. And if you're wondering, how do I switch back to classic Google Maps colors? Well, you don't. A lot of users aren't happy with the color change, so we'll see if Google sticks to this or reverts back. The second big Google Maps update that is coming is transit route recommendations. Google is updating transit directions so you can easily see the best route to your destination based on key factors, like your estimated time of arrival, number of transfers, the length of your trip, and so on. Plus, you'll even be able to customize your route further with handy filters that let you select the type of transit you want to take, or even choose a route with less walking. You'll also see where the station entrances and exits are, including what side of the street they're on, and a clear walking route to and from. How great is that? This is rolling out now to 80 cities worldwide to start. So if you're in Paris, Toronto, Singapore, Boston, Madrid, New York, or any of the other lucky cities that happen to have this feature already, let me know in the comments below if you're loving it. All right, the next big Google Maps update are some cool things you can do with lists. If you haven't been using lists in Google Maps, well, you haven't been living. But don't worry, I have a video on that listed for you in the description below. The lists in Google Maps, not the not living part. First, you can now customize your list with its own emoji. On Android or iOS, you're gonna tap on your Save tab at the bottom to bring up your lists. Here, you can tap New List to create a new one. And now at the top, you can add an emoji so that the places in that list are identified on the map with that emoji. So let's say this is a list of favorite sushi restaurants. We can name the list and add any description that we'd wanna add. And now our favorite sushi places are denoted with that cute little emoji on the map. And now it's easier than ever to share a list and collaborate with friends. Now, when you create a list or want to save a location, you can tap on Invite Collaborators to share a place in Maps with friends. So you're gonna be able to instantly create a collaborative list here. This is perfect to start planning your next big trip because everyone shared can add places to the list and can vote with an emoji on, say, whether or not they want to visit that spot. So someone in the group could give it a heart or maybe a thumbs down if they aren't really interested in visiting that spot. And if you thought emojis were only for lists, well, you'd be wrong. You'll soon be able to add emoji reactions to images and videos that other users have left as reviews on points of interest. So I don't have this yet, but you'll leave emoji reactions in the reviews section of Google Maps. When you see a photo or video, you're gonna have a little heart icon that you can hold to get different emoji reactions to appear where you'll pick your emoji of choice. Google will use AI and Emoji Kitchen to tailor an emoji reaction to that particular photo and emoji. So like in this example that they show, it's a mashup of a yum face and a bagel. Emoji reactions are rolling out now, so I'm curious to know if you have them and if you've used them yet and if you like them. So let me know in the comments below. Now, before I let you go, it's also important to let you know that Google Maps is just faster now. It's loading faster on both iOS and Android, and it's downloading maps for offline use faster too. If you're wondering how to download Google Maps for offline use, you're in luck. I have a video on that and, I don't know, a million other Google Maps tips and tricks all listed for you in the description below. But lastly, I want to leave you with a little known Google Maps tip. You can check gas prices right inside Google Maps. So if you're headed out on a road trip this holiday season, save this tip. Simply search for gas prices. And just like that, Google Maps will pull up all the gas stations near you and their pricing. It really only won't show Costco prices for me here, but at a quick glance, I can see the name and address of the station, how far it is, which for some reason that's only on iOS, by the way, and I can see the price. So I know if I'm getting the best deal. No third-party app required. How neat is that? So if you want even more Google Maps tips and tricks, like how to find the most fuel-efficient route in Google Maps, how to add music to Google Maps, I have all that and more listed for you via the links in the description below. Until then, have safe travels this holiday season, friends. So those are the best Google Maps updates just in time for holiday travel. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Google Maps updates or settings and why? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Google Maps content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.